Something tells me next year at CES, it's going to be all about AI-powered hardware. Not that there's not some of that now. There is. It's just I bet folks are hard at work on things that are still a year or two out. But here's the most interesting one I've seen so far this year. Rabbit is a startup that has introduced a hardware AI device, the R1, priced at $199. This gadget resembles a Playdate console or a small handheld TV from the 90s, and it aims to streamline everyday tasks, but it's not exactly designed to replace smartphones. In fact, it doesn't connect to your phone at all, but it wants to do what your phone does for you simply by interacting it with voice. You know, order an Uber, respond to a text, buy your groceries, but all via an agent, an AI agent who acts on your behalf with the apps obviated underneath. The R1 features a 2.88-inch touchscreen, a rotating camera, and a scroll wheel slash button for navigation and interaction with its built-in assistant. It's powered by a 2.3 gigahertz MediaTek processor with 4 gigabytes of memory and 128 gigabytes of storage, encased in a body designed by Teenage Engineering. It wants you to interact with it like you interact with ChatGPT if you mainly interacted with ChatGPT via voice. The essence of the R1 lies in its software, Rabbit OS, and its underlying AI technology. Unlike standard large language models, Rabbit OS is based on what it calls a large action model, or LAM, functioning as a universal controller for apps. This operating system can manage various tasks like controlling music, sending messages through a single interface without the need for multiple apps and logins. Innovatively, Rabbit trained its LAM by human interactions with existing apps, teaching it to recognize and use app interfaces and functionalities for you. This approach bypasses the need for developing specific APIs or seeking developer support for the R1. The R1 also includes a training mode, allowing users to teach the device new tasks, which it can then autonomously perform. This feature offers personalized automation capabilities. Concerning privacy and security, Rabbit claims no storage of user credentials for third-party services, and authentication occurs through those services' systems. The device's push-to-talk functionality ensures it only records audio when activated, addressing continuous listening concerns. Rabbit OS does integrate large language models for intent understanding powered by OpenAI's ChatGPT and Rabbit's own LAMs for task execution. The R1 is capable of executing complex errands requiring real-time interactions like travel planning or grocery shopping. An upcoming update will introduce a teach mode, further enhancing its capabilities to learn new tasks directly from user demonstrations. This is interesting. Basically, a smartphone that can do everything you do on a smartphone, but no tapping on a screen. Apps, but you don't interact with them yourself. The agent does. Maybe more interesting than that humane device? I mean, it still requires you to pay $200 for a totally separate device in your pocket, but this is getting at a new idea in mobile compute interface, which is what I'm interested in.